Hi everyone, welcome to Civil Engineers Educator, and today our topic is types of cement. And coming to the OPC is nothing but ordinary Portland cement. The name ordinary Portland cement is came from the Portland. It is discovered in the place Portland. It is in the England. Okay, it is in the country of England. And in the OPC it consists of three grades of cement. One is 33 grade, one is 43 grade, and final one 53 grade. Okay, it is depends upon the size of the particle of the cement particles. Okay, and it also depends upon the strength after curing of 28 days. It will be 33 newton per mm square. When we test the cement, we will get for 33 grade of cement, we will get 33 newton per mm square strength, and for 43 grades we will get 43 newtons per mm square, and for 53 grade we will get per mm square. Basically OPC is used in the concreting purpose for RCC structures. RCC means reinforced cement concrete structures, and for masonry works, and it is resistant to shrinkage cracks. Okay, and it is less resistance to chemical attack. Okay, less resistant to chemical attack, and it is used for masonry works basically. And coming to rapid hardening cement, and it is referred to the IS code book number 8041 1990 revised. And mainly rapid hardening cement is nothing but it contains quick setting. It contains quick setting than the normal OPC grade cements. Okay, and it contains more C3S compounds. Okay, this is under Boggs compounds, and it will have more fine grinding than the OPC cement. If we have more fine grinding, it also increases the strength and setting time of the cement. And generally for OPC cement, if the strength gain by a concrete cube is 70%, and if we take the rapid hardening cement, it will give results for one day, it will achieve of 70% return. Basically rapid hardening cement is used in the prefabrication industry and pre-stressor concrete, and for the road repair works, and also in the cold concreting, where cold concreting is happening. Cold concreting means where the weather is so cold, and it is also used in the where we have to remove the formwork fastly, we will use the rapid hardening cement. Okay, coming to the extra rapid hardening cement, generally rapid hardening cement is mixed with 0 to 2% of calcium chloride, which will decrease the setting time of cement from 20 minutes. Okay, we have to mix, place and transport the concrete in the span of 20 minutes. Okay, by using the extra rapid hardening cement, we can achieve 25% more strength with compared to the OPC. In generally in the initial stage, we will get in by using the extra rapid hardening cement, we will get more strength, 25%, but after some time, you will take us 1 year, it will be same for OPC and extra rapid hardening cement, and the heat evolved is mold. And the application of rapid hardening cement is used in the where the cold weathering condition the concrete is happening, we can use the extra rapid hardening cement, and for pre-stressor concrete also. And coming to the sulfate resistant cement, we will use the sulfate resisting cement to resist the sulfuric attack. It is mainly at marine places, okay, and near the seashore it is used. We generally, due to the sulfuric attack, it will it will get corrosion fastly and it may cause the deterioration of the structure. And it also decreases the durability of the concrete. So the places where we can use cement is marine structures, sewage pipes, and the soil where it exhibits the sulfate, we can use the sulfate resisting cement. Coming to Portland slag cement, and it is refers to the IS 455-1989 revised Indian Standard Code Book. Okay, and it is prepared from the Portland clinker plus excess of gypsum is plus GGBS. Here GGBS is nothing but the waste product from the thermal power plants and steel plants. We can have the GGBS, we can also call it as slag. It is a byproduct and we can use the slag from 20-50% of material in the manufacturing of Portland slag cement. And after manufacturing of Portland slag cement, and initially the strength is low for Portland slag cement compared to the OPC. OPC is nothing but ordinary Portland cement. After certain time, like we can take for 1 year, it is same as strength for OPC and Portland slag cement, and it gives low heat of hydration. And advantages of Portland slag cement is, first one is it reduces the permeability and it is less chemical attack and it gives low heat of hydration. And coming to the topic, quick setting cement. In the name itself, it is showing that the quick setting cement is nothing but it is used to set the concrete or mortar paste in the less time. It is called quick setting of cement. Due to the decreasing of gypsum while manufacturing of the cement, in the mixing of the clinker itself, the mixing of gypsum is decreased. We can have the quick setting of cement. By using the quick setting cement in the concreting, we have to place the concrete fastly. Okay, generally the application of quick setting cement is used in the construction of water constructions like footings in dams, footings of dams, and for grouting purpose it is mainly used. And coming to the super sulfated cement, it is comes under the IS codal provision of 6909-1990 revised. And super sulfated cement consists of 80-85% of slag and 10-15% of burnt gypsum and 5% of Portland cement clinker. Due to the presence of 80-85% of slag, we can see the low heat of it produces the low heat of hydration. And by using the 5% means less percentage of Portland cement clinker, we can have low heat of hydration of the cement. Generally it is also resisted to less chemical attack. And it is used in the places where, and it is also more finer than OPC, because due to the fineness it also increases the strength of the cement. And application of the super sulfated cement we can use in the where we have to resist the sulfur, and in the marine structures, in the mass concretings, and sewage pipes, And we can also use the way the soil exhibits the sulfuric cation. We can use the super sulfated cement. And coming to the low heat cement, and it is considered under the IS 12600:1981 revised. And the low heat cement generally due to the C3S and C3AF particles, by decreasing these particles in the manufacturing in the cement process, we can achieve the low heat cement. By achieving the low heat cement, we can decrease the heat of hydration. And we know that the cement exhibits the exothermic reaction, and means exothermic means which evolves the heat content. So to minimize the heat content in that, it is used in the mass concreting means where we are going for massive structures like dams, bridges, piles, etc. Portland pozzolana cement, we can call it as PPC. Okay, and it is comes under the IS 1489. It is revised in 1991, and it constitute of particles like OPC of 10 to 25% and pozzolanic material. Here pozzolanic material means it comes under two types. One is fly ash type and another one is calcinated. You can have two parts in the IS coral provisions. And due to using of Portland pozzolana cement, we can, and the density is low compared to the ordinary Portland cement, and it is finely mixed. Due to finely mixed, the strength also may increase, and due to finely mix, it decreases the micro cracks like shrinkage cracks. Okay, and it also reduces the permeability and increases the durability of concrete or mortar paste. Permeability means alloyance of water. It is resistant to water. It is like waterproofing agent, and it also liberates low heat while comparing to the ordinary Portland cement. And coming to the applications, okay, applications of the Portland pozzolana cement, it is used in the concreting purpose of hydraulic structures such as piles of dams and footings of dams, and marine structures and sewers. And it is low cost compared to the ordinary Portland cement. Coming to the Portland pozzolana cement, the strength may low compared to OPC. At certain time it will reaches the strength of the OPC. Okay, at the certain time the strength of the OPC is equal to the strength of the PPC. Like it may take 365 days or it may be more. Colored cement, in the manufacturing of colored cement, generally we have a color of gray color. Okay, for to produce the gray color, we are using FeO3, means iron oxide, to have gray color. For manufacturing of colored cement here mainly represents the white cement. It contains of minimum 1% of FeO3, means iron oxide, and it is contain 97% of calcium carbide and 0.03% of iron oxide. And the calcium carbide is mainly available at the places where Jodhpur, at Rajasthan, and this limestone is used in the manufacturing of white cement. Generally the cement also have various colors like red, gray, brown, etc. And this colored cement is mainly used in the grouting of floors, and to have aesthetic view. For aesthetics, colored cement also used